Hello and welcome to 10 Star Ground Coffee, a few minutes on ground engineering to enjoy while having your coffee. Well, you find us in Washington D.C. at the 99th annual meeting of the TRB. What's the TRB? The Transportation Research Board. And they're celebrating their centenary later this year. So at the convention center, there are over 13,000 transportation professionals and academics having discussions about the latest developments in all areas of transportation engineering. So I thought, what can I talk about in Washington DC related to transportation and ground engineering? Well, of course, the iconic metro stations of Washington DC. So here we are at Gallery Place Chinatown station. Doesn't the station look impressive, this large vaulted structure? Very open. It looks very modern, doesn't it? Actually, this station was built in 1976, but it still looks really modern, doesn't it? Okay, back to me, Brian, and I'll talk a little bit about how these stations and the metro were constructed. Like a lot of shallow metros, they were constructed by the cut and cover tunneling method. So a large trench would be excavated along the street. You'd build the track work at the base and then put in a roof to form the tunnel. And then you backfill over the top and build the road so that you can then open the road to traffic. So you have traffic across the full road and over the top of the metro lines underneath. And this is the roof of the tunnel that you can see, and this is supporting the roadway above. Now, other metro systems have been built like this, such as the New York subway. But if you go into a station, it's much more cramped with low ceilings, a much more utilitarian style with all the columns along the platform. So how come the Washington Metro has this very open style? Well, that is thanks to the designers of the original metro system, in particular, Harry Weese, the famous modernist architect. It was their vision to have a very clean, monumental style to the stations. So the result was this award-winning Brutalist example of architecture. Brutalist because of the very bold and rigid geometric shapes formed out of concrete. And for me, it's very reminiscent of the large train sheds of the grand stations that you see, particularly in Europe and North America. But of course, this is all underground, supporting the street above. And it's very gratifying to see a successful marriage like this of architecture and ground engineering. Okay, that's all for this episode of Tensile Ground Coffee. Thanks for watching. We better get back to the convention center, Brian. Which platform is it? Back to the convention center? You don't know? Okay, see you next time.